prophets, but there ain't no one prophecy in the Quran. And anything that the Quran says that's true is because they stole it from the scriptures.
Right,
man.
Right.
That's why in the Quran it says that the true children of God are the Israelites.
That's right.
Not you Ishmaelites. Arabs. Not you Arabs.
Hey, and also says that the author of their religion is Abraham, which go back to the Bible.
That's right, right. Man. That's right, man. The Most High, so miss us with that BS about the Quran and all that, and Islam and all that crap. Okay? The Lord ain't dealing with Islam. The Lord ain't dealing with religion.
That's right.
All of them dealing with the truth. Man. Yeah. All these falsified religions, all of the current Christianity that you see up in these black, stupid, idiot churches with the black woman rolling all over the ground looking stupid, and homosexuals clapping at the piano, the stupid Kabbalah and the dumb fat Moabite Buddhism. It's all falsified crap.
Yes,
right. And it all goes back to Babylonian custom.
Right. All of that.
And Samaria, even before that too.
Yes.
Because people don't understand, when Adam and Eve was on the scene, there was other people on the earth too. They were separated. They were separated from the other nations, man. When you understand the scriptures. All right? You always have false doctrines going on all across the world. And that's what you see now.
You gotta hate the way you
And that's what you see now, man. The scriptures is all about history, prophecy, and laws, statutes, and commandments. The first parts of the book is simply teaching you how to live, how to be clean on the planet. That's why America and the whole world is so damn dirty. Because they break every single one of the laws, statutes, and commandments in the Bible.
Right.
One of them being, we always like to use, is the land Sabbath. You don't supposed to farm the land. You're supposed to give the land rest for a year after 6 years, man. Alright? And there's supposed to be seeds in the food. There ain't no supposed to be no seedless grapes, no seedless oranges. That's an abomination, man. All these GMO foods, you wonder why cancer, leukemia, high blood pressure, diabetes, autism, multiple sclerosis, and all these other incurable diseases are going on. It's because look at the foods that you eat. You're not, this machine is not receiving any good fuel, man. It's like having a Range Rover and put some unleaded in it. You got to get that premium, baby. Alright?
We got a precept.
Go ahead.
Jeremiah 12 and 4. How long shall the land mourn and the herbs of every field wither?
And that's what's happened all across the land, man. You eat some food, but you're still hungry.
Yep.
You eat 3 plates of food, but you're still hungry.
Yep,
because there's no nutrition in the food.
Yep. You eat to feed your cells, man.
Yep.
And when your cells don't get the nutrition that's supposed to be in the food, you're hungry again because your cells are not being fulfilled with the food, the nutrient that's in that specific fruit, man.
Right. So you're not receiving the type of elements, the ionic, your whole body is all out of whack, man. There's something in the body that you learn in school called homeostasis. Meaning it's just a balance of the type of minerals and basically the ionic compounds that you need to exist, man. That's all thrown off, man. That's why our people look the way they do, man.
Go ahead, I ain't gonna go in.
How long shall the land mourn and the herbs of every field wither for the wickedness of them that dwell therein?
Yep.
The beasts are consumed, and the birds, because they said he shall not see our last end.
And that's what happened, man. You got the so-called white man in power, man. He's compelled to destroy every damn thing, man.
Right.
He will never stop hunting. He will never stop overfarming the land. He will never stop cutting down the rainforest. He will never stop mining for oil and natural gas, when there's all different types of natural ways to create energy and to produce. Right? Because the wicked are ruling right now. That's why the earth and the land is defiled the way it is. That's why you have, like I always say, a record amount of extinct and endangered species. That's why you have to buy Brita filters. You can't just drink any water because it's got rocket fuel, antibiotics, barium sulfate, fluoride, and all types of madness in it. That's why you you want to go to Whole Foods and spend your whole check to get some type of organic food, which is still BS. You know, there's nothing pure and natural about anything that you take and ingest into your
body. The air you breathe in. Every day you look up, what do you see? An airplane spraying something in the sky. Do you ever stop and say, what in the hell are they spraying that in the sky for? And making it a point to do it every day. That is ruining your health, man.
Yep.
Chemtrails, why do you think people have cancer at 40?
Yep.
20.
Children have autism.
Yeah, the proliferation, the whole proliferation of your DNA is being thrown off.
That's right.
Now, you have the Edomites doing some type of research called stem cell research. What do they do with stem cell research? Whenever you are in an embryonic state, the cells proliferate from something called a mesenchymal cell. The mesenchymal cell holds the DNA codes for all the different types of tissues in your body, whether that be heart tissue, or brain tissue, or bone tissue, or skin tissue, or teeth, or whatever it is. Our bodies are so polluted at a young age that those mesenchymal cells are thrown off very early, man. The body is supposed to cure itself. It's supposed to self-rejuvenate.
Right.
You don't even have the ions in your body to self-rejuvenate. That's why you have people at the age of 42, because their dopamine receptors are all thrown off, and now you have to take some type of serotonin reuptake inhibitor to trick your brain into thinking that it's releasing dopamine, man.
Right.
That's why you have these kids that can't sit for 20 minutes and pay attention in class. He has ADHD.
And you give him medicine.
No, he doesn't have ADHD. He doesn't have the proper things in his body to think straight, man.
Right.
Okay? That's what's happening, man. Everything in your reality is thrown off from its natural course.
Right.
That's why you have to take magnesium, calcium, vitamin D supplements.
Right.
You know? You can't just work out.
Yeah.
You can't just eat a good meal and go work out. You are going to be tired as hell. All right?
Go ahead. And you so-called white people, y'all racist proud while y'all doing it. Because y'all are the head of that, man.
Yep.
Because y'all are ruling the earth, passing the laws, saying this food. Y'all doing all these things and y'all proud while y'all doing it. And y'all think that judgment is not coming for it.
Yep.
Because y'all think that y'all land America is going to endure forever.
Yep.
Having us in slavery, having Negroes, Latinos, and Natives in slavery is going to endure forever.
Yeah,
okay?
And all of this is going on. Everything this brother just brought up, who do you see on the news as the problem? Chris Brown.
That's who we need to go
capture. The N-word.
Yeah.
Here it is. You're killing people. You have genetically modified foods. Look up Monsanto.
Yeah.
That's the mafia, man. They basically run as the mafia. They go to all these small farmers and say, you're going to use these seeds.
Yeah.
Which only lasts a year or a certain amount of season. Then you got to go back to them and get it. But nobody's talking about that.
Yep.
The only problem, everything everybody talking about is a nigga.
Yep.
A nigga who may have beat his wife.
Yeah.
a nigga who called somebody a Mexican.
Yeah.
Or a gay nigga.
Somebody who's talking, you call somebody a homosexual. You call a gay person gay, now you're on the news.
Yeah.
But meanwhile, these people are going all around the world ruining everybody's life, ruining your children's life, and they get no flack from you people, man.
Yep.
We're the problem, but then look at what this man is doing,
somehow,
man.
Somehow the Negro and Latino are the biggest criminals.
Yes. Man.
What are you talking about?
Which they ain't shit, two-thirds of them.
Yeah, yeah. Don't get me wrong. Most of our people ain't shit.
Yeah.
We're not saying that. But what we're saying is the biggest criminal on the planet in history has been you so-called white people.
Right.
Everything's fucked up because of you.
That's
why no one likes you. But you've had the sword for so long, and you've been able to beat everybody into the damn dirt for so long, you've become proud. You think that you actually deserve something.
Hold on, guys.
Let's talk about this. We gotta love.
They're entitled.
I just wanna be your friend. I just wanna be you guys' friend. You've been saying that for millennia.
Yeah,
while you killing everything.
Yeah,
no, I don't trust you.
Right.
I don't wanna be your friend.
Right.
I don't wanna make amends.
That's right.
You have to be removed.
That's right.
Right.
Okay? The Bible says it. The word of the Heavenly Father says, and it's happening. It's happening right before our eyes. Your kingdom is systematically crumbling, and it's going to culminate in the third world war and the most historic destruction in the history of the world. This has to go.
Right.
It's anti-life. It's anti-production. It's anti-righteousness. It's anti-future and health. All right? This system that you've created has been the most diabolical disease system in the history of the world. And it's going to fail in the most historic way.
Right.
All right?
Go ahead.
And we got kids, man.
Yeah.
We got kids back here on your own television on a commercial, two men are kissing, man. And I got to go and run and turn it off for my son to see it, man.
Right.
Yep. And then you be late. Sometimes you don't
Sometimes make it to
the button on time.
Yeah.
And they see that shit.
Yep.
That's crazy. Yeah.
You think that we're going to accept the only hope for my kid is to be the next Emmitt Smith or LeBron James?
Right.
Hell no.
That's fucked,
fuck LeBron James.
Right.
Yeah.
No. We're going to rule the world, man, the way it should be ran.
Right.
We ain't going to allow Exxon Mobil to tell me that I can't make an electromagnetic vehicle that can run off free energy.
Right.
We're not going to shut that down.
We ain't gonna need
you ain't going to need a fucking passport to go to another country.
That's right.
I want to go to another country because I want to go, damn it.
That's right. The earth belongs to us, man.
That's right.
You, I got to ask.
You got to tell me I can go? Fuck
after
you.
You stole it.
Yeah, you see, yeah, you stole it.
That's right, man.
You can do this, you can do that.
That's right, Christ.
You so-called white people have some nerve, man. Y'all got some nerve, man.
Go ahead.
Jeremiah, chapter 59, 49, Salakia, verse 7. Concerning Edom, thus saith the Lord of hosts, is wisdom no more in Teman? Edom is you so-called white people. That is your biblical nationality. All right, go ahead.
Is wisdom no more in Teman?
That was the chief city in Edom. Go ahead.
Is counsel perished from the prudent?
Uh-huh.
Is there wisdom vanished?
Has all your smartness vanished? Has all this intellect and your geopolitical systems that you've created withered away? I thought you were in control. Go ahead.
Flee ye, turn back, dwell deep, O inhabitants of Dedan, for I will bring the calamity of Esau upon him. The time that I will visit him. If grape gatherers come to thee, would they not leave some gleaning grapes?
Read.
If thieves by night, they will destroy till they have enough. But I have made Esau bare.
The Most High way, he's not gonna leave a little bit of you. You don't deserve for any of you to be left. Your whole family, because of what you've done, eventually is going to be removed. Okay? Go ahead. Calamity is coming for your nation.
That's right.
Hardcore.
Okay?
Feel like you're good or bad.
It's not because we said it. It's because it was the Heavenly Father's magnificent plan. Just as you understood, it was manifest destiny for you to go to the East Coast, all the way to the West Coast and conquer. It's manifest destiny for your whole nation to go into captivity, build up the next kingdom, and then be removed.
Yep.
There's not going to be any grapes gleaning.
That's right.
Go ahead.
But I've made Esau bare. I have uncovered his secret places, and he shall not be able to hide himself.
You're not going to be able to hide yourself. No underground bunkers, no probes to Mars, no secret councils.
Taking monkeys to outer space, man.
No cloning.
What the hell is wrong with you people?
Taking you're going to be completely exposed. That's what's happening. Go ahead. Yeah, no transhuman. You're not gonna go connect yourself with some type of android robot and live for 1,000 years.
Transhumans.
No.
It's over, man.
Take a damn monkey. You took monkeys out of space, man. Tripping, man.
Yeah. You so-called white people shot a missile at the moon to see if there was water. You're out of control. Your nation is out of control. There's millions of tons of space debris to where you're like, it's just outer space. We're just going to dump it out there. It's orbiting to the earth.
Yes.
Trash. It's orbiting the place that we live. You have trash orbiting it.
Right.
You're out of control. Your nation is out of control.
You tripping, dog.
Go ahead.
His seed is spoiled, and his brethren and his neighbors, and he is not. Leave thy fatherless children, I will preserve them alive, and let thy widows trust in me.
And let your widows trust in me,
break that
man.
Down, Nate.
Yeah. So we're gonna take, you're gonna be brought down. The sons that are left across the world, we're gonna take them. Some of you white women are gonna be happy, cause we're gonna be dealing with you. All right. You're gonna be soaking in little honey baths, preparing your bodies to be ravaged by a real man.
That's right.
All right. But you ugly white women are gonna be breaking bricks.
That's right.
All right.
Flips you Flintstone looking.
All right. Go ahead.
For thus said the Lord.
Yeah, cause that's what you did to our people, man. The pretty people, the fine Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. What do you think them white boys was doing? They was popping them. All right.
In front of the husband.
You know?
They come take the woman while she was with her husband and rape her right in front of the kid and the husband, man.
Right. All right.
Then you fed our kids to alligators, man. You're not going to get away with none of that, man.
Yep.
Nope. You ain't getting away with it, man.
Yep. You so-called white people have ran amok across the world for long enough. And the Bible prescribes your downfall, man.
That's right.
And it's coming, man. The tension between the U.S. and Russia is never going to end. The tension between the U.S. and Iran is never going to end. The tension between the U.S. and North Korea is never going to end. And especially now, you're sending more and more and more. The tension between the so-called white man and the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American is never going to end. All right? And you see it now. They're putting all this propaganda in the news because race wars are coming. Race wars are coming. When economic collapse hits America, everybody's going to go to their side, man. Just like you have in a cafeteria. When you go into a high school cafeteria, everybody goes to their side. The only people that mix and mingle is the Negro.
They call it social segregation.
That's right.
Where you naturally go to your own people.
Right.
All right. Jeremiah 49, verse 12.
This would be it.
Okay. For thus said the Lord, behold, those judgments was not to drink of the cup, ever surely drunk it.
Uh-huh.
And art thou he that shall altogether go unpunished?
Uh-huh. And now it says those whose judgment were not to drink of the cup have surely drunk it. Meaning the chosen seed of Israel wasn't supposed to be in captivity. We were supposed to be ruling the earth in righteousness from the beginning. Because the Most High chose us. But he basically set us through this process of going off just so he could show his power, man. So we can be raised up and glorified. So if the chosen seed of the Lord went to captivity, you think the wicked is not going to go unpunished? You Edomites, you so-called white people? Go ahead.
Right. But thus said the Lord, behold, though they whose judgment was not to drink of the cup have assuredly drunk it. And art thou he that shall altogether go unpunished?
Uh-huh.
Thou shalt not go unpunished, uh-huh, but thou shalt surely drink of it.
Yeah, you're going to surely drink of it. You're going to drink of that cup. What is that cup? Oppression, slavery. All right? You're going to be under our feet. Go ahead.
Micah, this is the last scripture we're going to close up. Micah chapter 2 and 3. Therefore thus said the Lord, behold, against this family do I devise an evil from which ye shall not remove your neck.
You're not going to be able to remove your neck from this said evil. Go ahead.
Yep. For this time is, neither shall you go heartily, for this time is evil.
Yeah, man. What does the word evil mean? Bad times, man.
Right.
Evil is coming to the nation of Esau, man. You Edomites, you so-called white people, because you've done nothing but sown evil in the earth, man.
Play the left hand side.
You played the devil on the earth, so you're going to get the reward of the devil.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
You killed, you robbed, you raped, you murdered. That's what's going to happen to you. And you're not going to be able to remove your neck from it.
It's a universal law.
Go ahead.
And that day shall one take up a parable against you and lament with a doleful lamentation and say, we be utterly spoiled. He have changed the portion of my people. How hath he removed it from me, turning away? He have divided our field.
He have divided our fields, and that's what's going to happen, man. The dissolution and destruction, not only of just America, but this whole geopolitical structure that you created, man. All right? With the EU, with NATO, with the United Nations, is going to collapse, man. And you're watching it. And you're not going to be able to reason yourself out of it.
Right, brother.
Okay? So anybody else got something?
Yeah, hey, let me say this. This poster right here, you see this? This is y'all's future, man. Y'all bound down to our nation. That's gonna see. You wanted us to bow down to you, and our people have done that. Yeah. That's happened, but it's gonna reverse. You have to bow down to us, but in righteousness.
Yeah, that's right. But this is what's gonna happen, man.
It's a prophecy.
This is the only thing that you can calculate. You're not gonna be able to talk and tough guy yourself out of it. Look, guy, I understand, man. That's
really terrible. That time is over.
No, man, you're going down.
Yep, and we may look small, but that's how the Lord deals, man. He deals with the underdog, man. He ain't dealing with big numbers, man. Because I guarantee you, all around the world, is people we don't even see doing the same thing we're doing.
Man. Yeah, man.
So with that, we're going to say all praise to Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, double honors to the elders, and blessings to the elect. Blessings to you brothers out there. Keep fighting. There's going to be things that's going to challenge you, man, in your mind, in the spirit. But you better stay strong, man, and continue in the work, man.
Fuck you scoffers, man.
It's death to you, man. Shalom. Yeah.